Most people in our culture are socialized to believe that knowledge and the truth are absolute and unchanging. You might notice that one major goal of social institutions, including family, the school system, and religion, is to transfer the knowledge that has been developed over the ages. Under this model, the role of learners is to absorb this information passively, just like sponges.
Have you ever think before about your current situation without thinking? Are you just a follower, or are you refusing to believe in anything? Or you actually start to think critically, or are you just a combination of all? Don't worry, we will help you to investigate that.
Philosophers tried hard throughout the history to identify the most productive way of thinking that will guarantee, given every debatable point, its deserved value. They call the final desired stage the critical thinking stage, and each critical thinker must pass through two different steps just before the final step. But be careful, not everyone will complete the whole stages, as you might stuck in one of them for the rest of your life.
People in the Garden of Eden stage of thinking tend to see the world in terms of black and white, right and wrong. Their authorities determine what's right and what to believe. Just like in the famous biblical Garden of Eden, knowledge is absolute, unchanging, and in the sole position of authorities. You may consider your parents as one of your authorities who actually chose religion for you on your first day of birth. Are you great to follow it as just a tradition?
Ordinary people can never determine the truth of themselves. They must rely on the experts. If someone disagrees with what they have been told by authorities, then that person must be wrong. Unfortunately, there is no possibility of compromise or negotiation here.
Welcome to the extreme condition from the previous one. That starts when man realizes that he lost his life just because some authorities and dogmas. Then he decided to give everything the same value just before refusing to believe in any of them.
Philosophers said that this stage is dangerous and critical, but necessary as a transition point in your way of seeking the right thinking stage. The two opposing perspectives of stage 1 and 2 find their synthesis in stage 3, thinking critically. When people achieve this level of understanding, they recognize that some viewpoints are better than the other, not simply because authorities say so, but because there are standards or criteria we can use to evaluate the accuracy of beliefs. Along that perspective, you won't have a problem in debating the effectiveness of your beliefs, the degree of consistency with the others, the soundness of your reasons, and the reliability of your sources.
That will lead you to develop your own informed conclusions without any problem in such a modification or a change based on new information or better insights.
The road to become a critical thinker is a challenging journey that involves passing through different stages, ranging from simple to complex, in order to achieve an effective understanding of the world. A critical thinker is a person who has progressed through all of the stages to achieve a sophisticated understanding of the nature of the world.